Michael, this is a huge deal. I don't care if you don't care about technology. I don't know if those people are alive, but this is a big deal because the government is saying that essentially that this service should be available to everyone on an equal basis, and private companies should bear the cost.
This, if you use the internet, you should care about this, and we're definitely encouraged by the approach that the FCC is taking here.
Why?
What we've asked for is we want to make sure that there's no blocking. So any website you want to visit, as long as it's legal, you can get there. There's no throttling, meaning that your cable company can't degrade some of the content of a video site you want to visit. And there's no discrimination. And at the end of the day, internet users should be able to access whatever websites they want. And internet startups and big internet companies alike should be able to reach their customers.
I always use the example of Uber and Lyft. I know Uber and Lyft are both supporters of the Internet Association, but what if, I don't know, let's make up, you know, fantasy cable company, Mr. Burns Cable acquires Lyft and suddenly slows down all the Uber requests. The Uber business disappears and Lyft is your only option for a ride. And if someone invents something better, they can't actually get to customers as quickly as everybody else.
Yeah, that, and under net neutrality, that will be prevented. And frankly, competition is what has allowed the internet to flourish and become what it is today. You have companies like Uber and Lyft. Let them compete. Let the users decide. And the cable company or the ISP shouldn't decide who wins and who loses.
I'm not a big believer that the stock market knows much on a short-term basis, but Netflix shares sold off with this this news. And I wonder if it's because people look at Netflix and look at all the big companies that are behind the Internet Association and say, wow, these guys just open themselves up to more competition. Why do the big companies support the open internet when, in fact, they're the ones who have an advantage because they can either build their own networks like Google has or Apple has, or they can do other things like pay for it as Netflix has?
All of our member companies have thrived under competition, and when you look at what makes the internet great, it's really this idea of free enterprise and let the users decide. And frankly, our companies are much closer to their users than probably any other company or other industries you're looking at when you see the customer service that our companies offer. And they just care about their users and let them decide who's going to win and who's going to lose. And they're happy to have that fight.
Is it a cost concern as well? I mean, Netflix has spent probably tens of millions of dollars to pay to get their content faster to customers, faster than their competitors even.
I don't think so. I think it's just an issue of fairness, and you don't want to have a choke point in the network, anywhere in the network. And again, when you have your customers, you want to be able to reach your customers, you want your customers to be able to choose and reach you, and not have an ISP or some other middleman in the middle, either taking a toll or blocking or degrading content.